Hello everyone, this is Shiva and my teammate is Nagasai. Today we are going to present a paper on corner detection. The paper is titled as Robust Image Corner Detection Through Curvature Scale Space. It is an improved version of existing corner detectors and is very robust to noise. The author also presented a very novel technique to accurately detect the corner points. Before going into the paper, everyone should understand what is corner point and importance of it. A corner point is a point that can be uniquely represented. Corner detection is very important because various computer vision and image understanding systems require corner point for implementation. We see a few examples here. Here motion tracking, object recognition and image stitching are most commonly seen applications of corner detection. With the advent of VR games, automated cars and robotics and other fields, accurate motion tracking and image recognition became even more important, and it is very good to understand one of the key aspect of their implementation, which is corner detection. Then what is a good corner detector? The author considers following features as important criteria when determining the corners. They are: all true corners should be detected, no false corners should be detected, corner point should be well localized. Also, the corner point should be robust to noise so that it can be used in real world applications. Also, corner point should be detected efficiently. Then, are there no corner detectors before CSS satisfying this criteria? There are several corner detectors which were introduced before CSS. There are several corner detectors which work on based on different techniques. Harris and Moravec corner detector, which is famous and one of the first accurate corner detector techniques, used image intensity variations around a pixel to detect the corners. Some researchers proposed corner detectors based on gradient magnitudes and gradient angles. Some researchers also proposed correlation matrices which gives high values only at corner points. Some propose neural network based corner detector methods. But most are not robust to noise and fails to detect accurate corner points or detect false corners in some areas. In this paper, author compares his corner detector with three other corner detectors, namely Plessy corner detector, Kitchen and Rosenfield corner detector and Susan corner detector. Most of us have idea of Harris corner detector. Here Plessy corner detector is same as Harris corner detector. So we will try to give some principle behind Kitchen and Rosenfield corner detector and Susan corner detector. Kitchen and Rosenfield believed that the corner points are those points where curvature and gradient amplitude of edge curve are large. So they proposed a method of calculating corner response function C using the product of curvature K and gradient amplitude G. By setting a threshold on value of C, we can get the corner points. Next is Susan corner detector. Here examine point is considered as nucleus and decision whether it is a corner point or not is taken by examining circular neighborhood around the point. The point from the neighborhood whose brightness is approximately same as the brightness of the nucleus form the area referred to as bosom. Here if A, B, C, D and E are interest points, then the bosom area for these points is as shown here. If we set up a threshold such that if the bosom is less than the threshold, then it is a corner point. Then we can get only A as corner point if we set threshold as 26% of the area, etc. But it fails in several cases. Here we can see some of the cases. Here bosom area is very less, but it is not a corner point. Here also bosom area is very less, but the point is not a corner point. Here we can see some of the corner points detected using Susan corner detector. Here we can see it almost accurately detected many of the corner points when there is no noise in the image. Now let's talk about CSS corner detector that author presented in the paper. The CSS corner detector uses curvature scale space technique for extraction of curvature features from an input contour at different scales. Also, the author used canny edge detector for detecting the edges in the given image. We can use different edge detector, but canny edge detector gives best results, so author went ahead with canny edge detector. Author also proposed some improvements to canny edge detector for edges at 45 degrees and 135 degrees angles. In canny edge detector, the initial edges are found by calculating the gradients and setting up a threshold. After that, non-maximal subtraction is applied to ensure that the edge lines are thin and only 1 pixel wide. During the implementation of CSS corner detector, it was found that canny edge detector produces a Take edge when the edge orientation is 45 degrees and 135 degrees. The problem is caused because during non-maximal suppression, the pixels which are compared are in the direction of a gradient. So, and for 135 degrees and 45 degrees lines, the edge point points to non-edge pixels. In this figure, we can observe edge which is in 135 degrees direction. As we can see, the edge thickness is 2 pixels. Here we can see that clearly. Also, the gradient is pointing towards non-edge pixels. Here we can see this pixel is not the edge. This pixel is also not edge. So during non-maximal suppression, the edge is not getting thin. As an improvement to canyon edge detector, the author mentioned that during the final step, if the gradient direction is 135 degrees or 45 degrees, we will compare the pixels in horizontal and vertical direction for non-maximal suppression again, so that the edge becomes one pixel thin only. Now let's discuss what is curvature scale space. First, we should understand what is meant by curvature. Curvature in simple terms can be said as how much a curve is bending. It is inversely proportional to radius of curvature. Here we can see here the curvature is less, so the radius of circle fitted there is high. At the same time, here the curvature is more, so the radius of circle fitted there is very less. From this we can understand that in simpler terms, the curvature is inversely proportional to radius of curvature. And in the same principle, we can calculate curvature at any point of a curve. To calculate curvature at any point, first we should parameterize the curve using arc length parameter u. Here we can see initially the curve is parameterized by x of u as curve t equal to x of u comma y of u. This can be understood from this example here. Here we are parameterizing a circle as r cos theta comma r sin theta. Then the circle equation will be x square plus y square equal to r square. The parametric form will be p of r cos theta comma r sin theta. Similarly, for any curve, we have to parameterize using a parameter u. After that, in curvature scale space technique, evolved version of a curve t is calculated. It is calculated by using the following formula. Here, the x parameter and y parameter are convoluted with a Gaussian kernel of size sigma. By increasing the size sigma, we can decrease the noise and sudden variations in the curve. With curvature scale space technique, we can find the extrema values of curvatures in an area and also additional features like curvature zero crossing points. But in order to find this, first we should need to calculate the absolute value of curvature. This can be calculated by formula shown here. Here k represents the absolute value of curvature. Here x underscore u is nothing but first derivative of x dash, and x underscore uv means x double dash. And for calculating x dash and x double dash, to be computationally efficient, we should first take the derivative of Gaussian kernel and then convolute it with x of u, so that we can get the derivative of evolved versions. Also, to understand the equation of the curvature intuitively, we can write the numerator as cross product of x dash y dash and x double dash y double dash. Means first one is a tangent and second one represent how much the tangent is rotating. See, here we can see that at the corner point, the curvature changes, the tangent angle changes rapidly. Here tangent is in direction and here the tangent is in this direction. So it is rotating very high. The rotation value is very high. But from here to here, the rotation is not that much. Here also, this cross product also gives a physical value of this value. As we evolve the curve with increasing value of sigma, small variations in the curve will be removed. Here we can see there are small variations in the shape. These will be removed and the curve becomes simpler. See, as we are increasing the sigma value from here to here, all the small variations are removed and curve became simpler. Also, in an image, the edges are not smooth and we'll get a very high value of curvature at very fine scale due to noise in the digital contour. So, first we need to evolve the curve by increasing the sigma so that the small noises at the edges are removed. In CSS corner detection method, the corners are defined as local maximum of absolute curvature. As scale is increased, the noise is smoother away and only magma corresponding to real corners will remain. As we have said previously, we will increase the value of sigma because we want to remove the effects of noise. But with increasing value of sigma, the localization of corner points will become poor because the corner point may move slightly with increasing value of sigma. So to tackle this problem, we will track down this corner point by reducing the value of sigma and examining the corner points detected at a lower scales so that we can get the exact coordinates of the corner point. Also, there are local maxima on the evolved contours due to rounded corners or noise, but the value of curvature at these points will be lesser than the value of curvature detected due to real corner points. So we can set a threshold value t and remove these corner points. Also, the curvature of corner point should be double the curvature of a neighboring extremum. This is because for rounded corners, we may get the value higher than the threshold, but we don't want the rounded corner points. We want the real corner. So for real corners, the neighboring pixels will have very low value of curvature compared to the corner point. But for rounded corners, even neighboring pixels also have very high value of curvature. So in this way, these points can be removed. This is the algorithm proposed by author for corner detection in CSS corner detector. Here first we utilize the can edge detector to extract the edges in the virtual image. After that, we extract the edge contour by filling the gaps in the edges. At the same time, we will find the T-junction corners. Then we will compute the curvature at a high scale sigma and determine the corner candidate by comparing the maximum of curvature to threshold T and neighboring minimum. After that, we will track the corners to lower scale to improve the localization of the corner points. Finally, we will compare the T corners and CSS corners and remove the false corners or the corner points which are determined twice. Now my friend Nagasai will continue with the implementation aspects and showcase the results.
So hello, this is Nagasai. So after this scan edge detection, which is the first stage of CSS corner detection method, so here we can see the edge extraction image. So the next step in this would be filling the gaps and T-junction identification. So we can see that after the edge extraction method, CANI detector can also cause some gaps in otherwise continuous edges and also at T-junctions, and corners might not be found with the CSS method. So here, when the edge extraction method arrives at the endpoint of a contour, it performs two checks. If the endpoint is nearly connected to another endpoint, then it would fill the gap and take it as a continuous edge and the curvature values are found on this contour. And the second case would be if the endpoint is nearly connected to an edge contour but not to another endpoint, then it would be marked as T-junction corner, which is depicted over here. So using this edge extraction image and the method or algorithm which is mentioned earlier for finding the absolute value of curvature, so we would start with a large scale where high sigma value is selected and we would find the absolute values of curvature at these edge contours. So then local maximum of absolute curvature are the possible candidates for corner points. So here local maxima is either might be a corner or due to a rounded corner or due to a noise. So there will be these will be our initial corner points. So we need to eliminate these rounded corners and corners due to noise. So initially also we would set proper thresholding corresponding to sigma value. In fact, the threshold T would decrease with increase in sigma as we are making the image more smooth then with increase in sigma. So for removing these corners due to noise, as we are starting from high scale, i.e. smoothen image, and we are stopping at one proper particular sigma which is of less noise, so the corners due to noise are maximally suppressed. And the next one would be after this, for removing rounded corners, corner points are compared with the neighboring local minima. So the curvature of a corner should be twice that of one of the neighboring local minima. So in this way, rounded corners are also removed. So after this, when initial corners are detected, later as discussed before, only the proper corners are taken. Rounded and corners due to noise are eliminated. So next would be tracking, which would be still start from high scale value, which is having high sigma value. So using these corners while moving to low scale, we would examine corner candidates in a small neighborhood of the previous corners, compute curvatures at those locations, and later update would be done on corner locations. So tracking would be continued until it reaches the desired low scale value. So this process gives very good localization. So here, only a few curvature values need to be computed in the vicinity, and in a way, it would reduce computational cost by decreasing the operations of finding curvatures at each locations on the edge contour. So this would be just a modification that need to be done in which the false corners are removed. So as we mentioned before, in fact, we would start with the T corners because they're really true corners. And later corners are updated using curvature values, initial corners and tracking. So in this procedure, as we can see in the picture, the corner might be double times detected. Here we can see that one would be due to the curvature of continuous contour, and other will be at the exact same location due to the T corner. In fact, it is the Y junction over here, which is the case where corner is two times detected. So these T junction corners are compared to the corner points found with the CSS method, and if they are close to each other, the T junction corners are removed. So here the whole process of this is shown, which would include initial corners, tracking and removing false corners. So the experimental results. All detectors are implemented in Python, and using the source code, we are able to run the CSS method, and we got the results in our hand. So the Kitchen and Rosenfeld detector was the fastest of these detectors. Even we commented on the computational complexity of CSS while discussing tracking. So 80% of time used by CSS is spent in edge detection. CSS uses only two important parameters. Experiments showed that sigma equal to 4 gave good results with almost all the images. As commented before, threshold T depends on the value of sigma, and with sigma equal to 4, the threshold can be set to 0.03. Other values of sigma are also possible, and for a very noisy image, sigma equal to 8 and threshold T equal to 0.02 can be used. Starting with sigma equal to 4, tracking can be accomplished at sigma equal to 2, sigma equal to 1, and sigma final equal to 0.7. The final scale image should be as local as possible to ensure the good localization. Note, however, the detection of corners can be carried out at multiple scales. As a result, by adjusting the scales, the number of corner points required can increase or decrease depending on the requirements in the later processes. So for testing the proper functionality of CSS and checking whether it is working properly for every different type of case, we have taken different test cases for it. So for each and every image, CSS corner detector was tested, and the results are compared with the output of three other corner detectors. Note that we attempted the best possible results for each corner detector tested by searching for parameter values that appear to yield the best results. So first we have taken a normal artificial image with no noise. So we observed particularly in this portion where corners are not detected but successfully found in CSS. And also this edge has combined with lot of corner points. Even if we compare this both, this point which is at exact corner is not detected here. So in other corner detectors, thresholding cannot be done properly. So obviously corners may sometimes not be detected, like in this situation where intensity variation is low and points are removed during thresholdings, as background and object has nearly same intensity. Sometimes non-corner points can also give high values for function calculated as seen in the edge points. But CSS corner detector does not face any of these issues. So next we want to check for noised image. Particularly here, Gaussian noise is added. So we can observe, like in this case, even Susan detector that which has performed almost equal to CSS in the previous case has failed, as some corner points that are detected without noise are now removed due to the addition of noise. As we can see in Harris corner detector, some points are detected on edges because of surrounding noise, which makes it highly prone to noise. So noise does not affect CSS because during edge calculation, most noise is removed and corners detected are dependent on edges, which are less prone to noise than intensity variation and gradient. So here it is a real image of blocks. Much texture and noise is present in the image. So here Susan detector failed to detect obvious corner points due to the high value of threshold. Like here, for example, if we set threshold as 25% area of circle, here as top corners has 33% area failed to be detected, and Harris corner detected same as before due to the low intensity variation between the background and the foreground failed to be detected. So CSS even succeeded in the case of texture and noise. And then we want to check it on the image which is having some small details along with texture in real scenario. So here, same as before, large number of corners are detected on edges in Harris as they're not smooth, and also there is a lot of texture variations as house surface is rough, leading to additional wrong corners in other detectors. But CSS, however, succeeded in this case also, where image has some details along with textures in real scenario. Finally, a practical lab image is used which has some tilt. So same as before, CSS succeeded in detecting proper corners compared to other detectors. Even the image has some tilt. So now, what makes CSS detector more reliable? Firstly, CSS is more systematic in manner. CSS has proper solutions for removing rounded corners and corners due to noise at initial times. So in this way, it is succeeded in ignoring corners due to noise, which makes it not to get affected by noise. And proper sigma high and sigma final are selected with corresponding proper thresholds, which makes it more reliable. It should be pointed out that most corner detectors carry out some form of edge detection, either implicitly or explicitly. As a result, when they appear to directly applicable to the input image, the results are affected by implicit edge detection. The CSS detector, however, simply makes the process explicit. So for the scope of this project, as mentioned initially, will be on object detection and in motion tracking systems. So in motion tracking systems, the CSS detector makes both the image edges and image corners available for the later processes. It can also provide additional point features as well as the traditional corners. The new features are the curvature zero crossings or inflection points of the image edge contours, recovered in a similar way as the corners, that they can complement the traditional corners when used by the later processes. For example, they can be utilized with the motion tracking systems in an area of image when there is a lack of corners features. And also in object detection, suppose imagine a robot which is asked to pick up a particular shape of object presented before it. First, it must sense, i.e. identify its location, then reach near object and pick it up. Here we deal with two-dimensional analog of sensing the object. The vision of robot corresponds to the given image, and what is supposed to pick up is what we wish to find in that image. So here, object detection can be done using CSS detector by making use of contours for its detection, as because CSS detector is more reliable corner detector. So final conclusion. So our project is to verify the robustness of curvature scale space detector in image corner detection, and we successfully achieve the task of verifying its robustness in all scenarios, which makes it reliable compared to other detectors. References, and here are our references that we have used for making up this project. Thank you.